Hey, welcome back to Light Metaphors. This is Thomas. Just want to thank you for tuning in to the channel. If you haven't hit that subscribe button, go ahead and hit it. So today I want to share a little bit about one of the art pieces that I have that I've designed, and just give you a little insight on the spiritual creativity and what's behind the piece. And so I just want to pull out this this piece. It's here. Here we go. Yeah, this is an airbrush that I did. It's an airbrush on a cap, and you see that it's an eagle's eye, and it's the eagle's eye is on the right side of the cap. And people who have seen this cap before, who've seen me wear this, they wonder about it because it's only one eyeball, and that is kind of strange. But there's something behind the hat, and there's something behind the meaning of this hat, why it is that it's a hat with just one eye on it, and I want to explain the meaning behind it. And it's a prophetic symbol, as we know, as we understand that the eagle represents the prophetic, but the eye of the eagle just represents as well the prophetic, but the visionary aspect of the prophetic, you know, that the ability to see in the spirit via dreams and visions. And so like that eye, that's what it symbolizes. But the meaning of it being one eye only, it speaks of the having a singleness of focus or singleness of vision. You know, Jesus said in the scriptures that, and if your eye be single, your whole body will be full of light. If your eye single, your whole body is full of light, will be full of light. There's a cause and effect there. The state and condition of your eye determines whether your body would be full of light or full of darkness. And he says somewhere in the scriptures as well that he says, be careful then that the light within you is not darkness. That the light within you is not darkness. And there is such thing as a dark light, and it's like a perversion of light, preferred counterfeit light. But he's saying to be careful. In other words, if your eye is single, and single has a lot to do with a singleness of focus, of having no mixture within your mind, your thoughts, or your vision, your focus, no mixture, no impurities, it's no cloudiness. You have a singleness of vision or focus, and that's what God wants to have us all operate in, a singleness of vision and a singleness of focus. He wants to have that and have no distractions within, pulling us from the left and the right. He wants us to stay single, focused. And as we remain in that place and develop that singleness of focus, we'll see that the light within us begins to fill us and flow out of us. We're called to be light in the world. We once were darkness, but now we are light in the Lord. And therefore, we are to live like children of light. And so when our eyes are single, we have that singleness of focus. Our whole body is going to be full of light. The light's going to flood our being, flood up and out of our being and emanate around us. And we carry that light of His presence all around us wherever we go. And also the fact of if I painted the eye on the right side, you know, it symbolizes the creative side. It's the right hemisphere of the brain. That's where all creativity stems from. It springs forth from the right side. Visual arts, creative arts, the right hemisphere. It's where the intuitive visual flow of God will come in, and it'll rise up in that arena, in that area, where we begin to see in the mirror of the mind, which is the imagination, is the mirror of the mind. And that's where the picture flow from. It stems from that area. So that's why I put it on the right side. I airbrushed it on the right side of the hat. Speaking of the right hemisphere, the right side of the brain, it's the left side of the brain is where we get logic analytical thinking, logical thinking, but the right side is the side where creativity stems from. It's a side where prior to us being educated as infants and children, we operated more out of that creative right side of the brain. Our logic was not developed, and until we got education and developed logic. But God wants us to develop this area, this visionary area, the right side of our brain. He wants us to develop it. And one of the primary ways we can do that is to begin to learn how to visualize, to take what we a description of something that we read and to begin to imagine it. Now, God wants to bless your imagination. He wants to bless our imagination. He wants to sanctify it. One of the best ways, or one of the way to have a sanctified imagination, is through the scriptures. Jesus said, sanctify them in the truth. Your word is truth. Sanctify them in the truth. Your word is truth. And so when we take the words of God and we begin to imagine what we see, what we're reading, we begin to picture it, or we begin to take a description that one of the, in the Old Testament or in the New Testament, the John or the apostle in the New Testament, or Ezekiel in the Old Testament, describing something he saw in the spirit, or he's describing from God. We start to visualize that and see that in our mind. We begin to allow the word, the image of the word in our mind, and flooding our mind, and we visualize it, we meditate upon that, and in the process of that, there is a sanctifying power that's being released, because the truth sanctifies you, it sets you apart, it cleanses and washes you. And so that's how this realm of our imagination is more and more set apart for God to use it and to speak to us through it. And God wants to speak to us through the visionary realm. You know, He's called us to walk and see. Jesus said the Son does nothing unless He sees His Father doing it. Jesus lived the life of divine imagery. The Son can do nothing unless He first sees what the Father is doing. And whatever the Father does, He does. And we want to synchronize with God and begin to live in that realm where we can see what God's doing and synchronize with Him and do likewise and step out and do what He's doing as He's in us and doing it through us. As we allow Him to walk it out through us, and we co-labor with Him. So that's the, you know, singleness of vision, the single eye that's airbrushed on this hat. And so I just wanted to give explanation to this piece of artwork that God gave me as an idea to bring forth. And so this is just one piece. There's a lot of other art pieces that God has given me that I'm going to step into explaining the depths of it, what it contains within it. The words that are within the image, within the picture. And so it's just like kind of like the dream interpretation, or God speaks to us in pictures, and we take and dream interpretation is taking the pictures and putting words to them. So God communicates with us via pictures, metaphors, symbols, and parables, parables in a night season, and we take those pictures and those symbols and we put words to them. Well, there's words in art pieces. The art is loaded with many words. And so I just wanted to bring out some of the understanding of this piece of artwork that I did. And so my prayer right now for you is that God would begin to quicken your the eyes of your imagination, and that you would begin to operate, learn to sync with Him in what you see, that you'll enter into that place like a little child and receive the kingdom and begin to develop your visual side, that right hemisphere of your brain, that you begin to develop it and let the Word of God sanctify it and begin to trust God that He'll show you things, that you'll see what the Father is doing. So God bless you, and thank you again for checking out Light Metaphors. My prayer is that you'd be blessed and filled with the spirit of creativity, the spirit of wisdom and revelation. You know, the Spirit of God brooded over the surface of the deep in Genesis, prior to speaking things into existence and being in the natural. And my prayer is that God will brood over the surface of the deep of your mind, of your imagination, the deep of your imagination, begin to birth visual pictures that will be externally done on earth as you've seen them in the spirit. God bless you, and we'll see you again.